Hello, frugal friends. Welcome back to the channel. We're doing our weekly word today. We're going to be studying Galatians 5. We're going to start at 1, but we'll move down to 13 through 21. Okay, you guys. It is for freedom that Christ has set us free. Stand firm then, and do not let yourselves be burdened again by a yoke of slavery. So we have a free will. We are free in Christ. So we've been seeing a lot of things lately that have been, you know, unsettling in the world around us. All types of things that we would never do, or, you know, we can't imagine how someone would maybe harm a child, or, you know, just the hatred we see in this world, the discord, right? We see so much of that, but that's not that those people, that's living by the flesh, and we're not going to live by the flesh. We're going to live by the spirit. Okay. So let's move down to 13. You, my brothers, were called to be free, but do not use your freedom to indulge the sinful nature. Rather, serve one another in love. And see, we don't see that, right? People aren't serving each other in love. It's just all about self, right? In their flesh. The entire law is summed up in a single command. Love your neighbor as yourself. Thank you, Lord. If we did that, imagine if we were doing that, right? I'm not talking about you. I'm talking about the world around us. You know, imagine if people were doing that, loving them, their neighbor as they love themselves, right? But I see a lot of selfishness in the world. If you keep on biting and devouring each other, watch out, or you will be destroyed by each other. So I think that's what's happening, right? So I say, live by the Spirit, and you will be gratified. You will not gratify the desires of the sinful nature, for the sinful nature desires what is contrary to the Spirit, and the Spirit what is contrary to the sinful nature. They are in conflict with one another, so that you do not do what you want. So that's what people are doing. They're doing what they want to do. That's not of God. That's not of Christ. So when we see all these horrible things going on, that's not God. That's man acting in his free will, acting in his flesh or their flesh. But if you are led by the Spirit, you are not under the law. The acts of the sinful nature are obvious: sexual immorality, impurity and debauchery, idolatry and witchcraft, hatred, discord, jealousy, fits of rage, selfish ambitions, dissensions, factions, and envy, drunkenness, and orgies, and life. So we see a lot of that, right? We see a lot of that going on in the world. I warn you, as I did before, that's Paul. Paul is writing this letter, that those who live like this will not inherit the kingdom of God. So, God gives us a free will, and we can choose life or we can choose death. We could choose to live by the Spirit or we could choose to live by the flesh. So, when we're walking in the Spirit, you know, we don't want to do the things we see of the world, what the world is doing. And that's for us. It helps us, right? We have peace in that, and when we follow God, we have peace in our life. So I don't watch the news like I used to. I rarely watch the news because it's so much. I mean, it will keep you. It's dark. It's very dark. So Jesus is the light. Jesus is the one who said, they asked him, what was the commandment? And Jesus said, love, love. So we have to love, even if it's hard for us. We have to try to follow Jesus' commandment to love. That's not what we're seeing in the world. We're seeing a lot of hatred and all the other things I read off. But I just want you to know that that's not God. When you see these things, that's man. And man is following his flesh. It's not God. God loves us. God is the light. So thank you for joining me today, you guys. And as always, be blessed.